At OddBot, we're an animation studio that produces soup to nuts, 2D, CG, kids and family, projects that we've worked on, Muppet Babies for Disney Junior.
Is everything all right out here?
Yes, Miss Annie!
Action Pack for Netflix, and currently working on Playdate with Winnie the Pooh for Disney Junior.
What are we gonna play?
So we did two seasons traditionally, a traditional CG show of Winnie the Pooh, and then we decided that the third season we were gonna do all in Unreal. For the first two seasons, we never really got involved in the CG portion of the production. We would just get footage back and then give notes. Lots of notes, lots of drawovers, send it back. And now with Unreal Engine, we're able to scale up just a little bit, build up our team just slightly, and we can take on much more of the production. We have a lot more creative control and the ability to play a little bit more.
It's really about the fact that multiple departments can work simultaneously. We would have our 3D board artists laying out the 3D board, and we would start lighting right away. So animation is happening while lighting is happening. We're doing renders the whole time where we're checking the final look of it in storyboard. We've been iterating all the way through, and we just wind up with a final product that much more meets our expectations in a much faster timeline.
Lighting the season was a totally new thing for the entire crew. We've never had lighters in-house before. We had bi-weekly live lighting sessions, so we actually got to sit, tweak things in real time, and adjust as we went.
You can sit and look in the viewport and go, oh, could we tweak this a little bit? Can we adjust this rim light and see it happening in real time? And that was just this moment of, holy cow, what can't we do with this? Which is really exciting.
Owls softly hooting in the sky.
We definitely had a distinct challenge with Playdate with Winnie the Pooh, where we have all of these fuzzy characters and they have to feel super soft and charming. And all of the characters have a different look to them. We really set out to replicate with Unreal Engine all of those different kinds of fur looks and fur simulations to really give us that character range that we had in season one and two.
Most of the characters all had grooms, and the grooms consist of hundreds of thousands of follicles, and not only the characters, but we decided to use a groom system on the grass. So all of the sets that have grass are just one giant groom system, and at the end of the day, we were getting into the billions of hair follicles rendered at any given time. That actually allowed us an additional benefit for simulation. And we could now bend and move the grass to whatever we'd like to do. And we can see that in the viewport live. We can scrub back and forth. Let's make it more stiff. Let's make it more loose. And then we get that feedback and iteration real quick.
It's instant gratification. I feel like that's what we're all kind of hoping for, is we want to see it the way we want it instantly. And in this process, it's just done.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
One of the things that we run into with the projects that we're working on is more than ever, there's a demand for bespoke content for Instagram, YouTube, verticals, for reels, all these kinds of things. In a traditional pipeline that has to go all the way back to rendering and different layouts, and you've got to do a whole different camera pass. It's too costly, too time consuming. And with Unreal Engine, you can set up your camera much more easily, back it up, and just get everything that you want in your shot for your vertical much more quickly and render the whole episode and be able to generate that kind of companion content for social media channels really quickly and easily.
As a producer, it's always been a huge goal of mine to have a team that works incredibly well together as one unit and also gets to enjoy the fun of making cartoons, because we do make cartoons for a living. Unreal's brought out this beautiful collaboration that isn't necessarily needed in a more assembly line traditional pipeline.
You're one of my favorite crafts.
So this whole season was kind of a leap of faith for OddBot and Disney. Disney was so enthusiastic about what they were seeing early on. You know, we'd send through a storyboard that would have lighting and grass in it and character textures. Some of the storyboards looked like final renders. That really helped sort of just set everyone's expectations on what was possible.
Children's animation is challenging because there's this expectation that, you know, every show needs to look different and be different, which is one of the most exciting parts about children's animation. There's so many different styles and so many different looks. And with Unreal Engine, like, it's enabled us to play more, be creative, and that's really exciting.